So sometime in 2021, the folks at Blender Foundation did make an announcement of the roadmap that they've planned for Blender 3.x, and this came with a couple of interesting things which a lot of us were super excited about. One of the things that was talked about was Blender and the internet, as the core principle of Blender is it doesn't require the internet to work. But the folks at Blender Foundation also thought about the fact that they would like to create a dedicated website and server on blender.org that will be set up as proof of concept for rolling out online features. And by principle and by design, only free and open source services for everyone will be added there. And that is where the whole idea of creating an extension project came in. And we did see that the extension project was part of the project to look forward in 2024. And this was also a project that was talked about sometime in 2022. And it is quite interesting to see that today, that is right here. I mean, if we check out the projects to look forward in 2024, this actually made the first cut. Of course, we've already seen the GPU-based compositor sort of making its way into a newer version of Blender. But let's talk about this one, which is now here, as this is now a fully available website where you can start downloading and getting both add-ons, themes, and a couple of interesting things from. So if you go over to extension.blender.org, I'm going to put this link in the description so you can check it out. You'll be able to download as many things as possible that you can get from here. So if, first off, you do have add-ons you would like to share with the community, at this point, you can click on the upload button and upload that. And once you upload it, this will be queued for approval. And if you go over to the approval queue, you can see a couple of pending add-ons or themes that are waiting for approval. Over here, you would notice that you've got a couple of add-ons that are now here. And before you can upload any of your extensions, you need to create an account. But if you just want to simply download an add-on and work with, then you can go ahead and check out the tags or categories and see what add-on is currently available, and you can pick up from there. At this point, we have a limited number of add-ons that you can find on this page, and you can simply scroll through all these ones and see where you've got add-ons. Development has no add-on, the Bake has no add-on, I kind of believe the UVs has one add-on, Text Editor doesn't seem to have anyone, for the systems, I think we don't have anyone, the same thing can be said for rigging, I believe, and you know, other ones as well probably have either one or nothing. But then, if you just want to download add-ons, how you get to download these add-ons is pretty interesting. I think the folks at Blender Foundation are going for a particular style of working with files and other forms of data with Blender, which I'll explain later in the video. There is a romanticized way that the add-ons are supposed to be downloaded. So let me explain. By default, how you install add-ons in Blender, right here we're using Blender 4.2 the alpha. If you go over to edit, you go over to preference, and you go right here where you have your add-ons. This is basically how you install your add-ons. But with the extension, the romanticized way of installing add-ons would require a drag and drop. And how that works is very simple. So for example, let's say we would like to work with a light painter. And then if we simply drag this over to this part, and let's go ahead and expose Blender slightly, bring this right over here. And how you get to install this is considered to be this simple. By default, you know, just like you have with typical add-on pages, you do have some sneak peeks telling you how you get to work with this add-on, tools that you might be needing, all of that parameter stuff. You have all of that. And then this tells you who made the add-on, how many downloads you've got, what versions of Blender. And one thing which I did notice is most of their compatibility are for 4.2 and above. So the romanticized way is like this, that if you like to install anything, you click on get add-on and you drag and drop. Again, this is how it is supposed to work. One quick thing I'd like to also mention is this is currently in alpha, which means as alpha can be, lots of things do not work exactly how you think they will. So if I click drag and drop, we're supposed to get this add-on in here. So if we simply press N on the keyboard, you notice we don't have that add-on. And this is because this is still currently new. So if you're still thinking about downloading stuff from this, there's an alternative which gives you that option of manually downloading those add-ons and you can load them in. And the same thing can be said for every other one that we have here. So if we simply go all the way back, so let's just go in and take a look at all these other ones, the same thing can be said for them. So if I go in and pick up any of these, I can just click on that. Actually, let's take a look at this other one, which is the wireframe color. I think this is also a good one. So I can click on download. If I click drag and drop, by default, I'm supposed to be able to see something called a wireframe color set of tools under the object property. So if we do that and I go in here, go over to object property, we don't see it. And just like I mentioned, this is a romanticized way of installing add-on, and this may make it to the final build of this extension platform, but currently it is still a test instance, and some of these things needs to be taken with a grain of salt. On the other hand, we do have themes. So if we go over to the themes as well, let's see if this is going to work. We can click on get, and this also supports 4.2 and above, and I can click, drag and drop that in. So this is supposed to be like the Gold Pro, so it's a professional theme for, you know, having some gold like effect when you select stuff. Let's see if that works. Nope, it doesn't. So yeah, again, these things would work better if you just simply download them by simply using the download button and get them to work. Let's actually go ahead and check out these from the preference. If we go over to the themes, do we have that? No, so that still doesn't come in here, as we don't have anything that specifies Gold Pro when it has to do with the themes. So these add-ons are currently available, and I think this is more like an open call for developers and also those who have free add-ons that would like to upload theirs. You can come in here, upload your add-ons and get approval. And of course, once this makes it to final release, it is definitely something that I believe a lot of you guys may take advantage of. With this method of clicking, dragging and dropping into the viewport, I kind of think that this is how we might be working with Blender moving forward from 4.2. As 4.1, which will be announced sometime at the end of the month, has already shown its prowess of dragging and dropping both OBJ, STL and Alembic files in them. And with 4.2, FBX drag and drop will be coming, and with what we've just seen, if this gets to where it's going, then potentially Blender add-ons will be loaded by simply dragging and dropping, making going over to the edit, going over to preference and the add-on section something that might be obsolete or totally redundant. For the add-ons that we've just shown, these add-ons are super cool. You can download them manually, get them to work, and you can do some more interesting things with it. And speaking about add-ons, there is a cool new add-on that just came out, and I think maybe I should just talk about it right now. So if you go over to Smiles's page, he just announced a new add-on, which I think is pretty cool. And of course, we're going to make a full add-on video about this one later. And this is currently doing a 75% off, which is a launch offer. It's called the Gobo Plus. It's got the 4K thing going for it. And if you're into gobos, you're into laser projections, or probably you like to get some stuff that includes caustics, all that stuff, this is available. And it comes with 53 presets, 12 animated 4K stuff, and 41 procedural assets. You can go in and pick this up. And of course, if you like to get any of these themes or any of these add-ons that we've just talked about or showed off, you can go over to extension.blender.org and grab those ones for yourself. So this is it. Blender extension is now a thing, and it's currently in alpha. If you're a developer and you like to get your stuff on Blender extensions, then this might just be the right time for you to plug it in and get approval. And for those who've been asking for the Blender 4.1 video, this video is coming once Blender 4.1 gets finally released. We do believe that the holdback is for bug fixes and a couple other features that might be coming to 4.1, which hasn't been finalized yet. And once that happens, we will be making a full video about that one and sharing every single thing about the new version of Blender. So keep your eyes peeled on the channel and check out for more updates. Tell me what you guys think about this one in the comment section. And of course, if you like this video or you learned something from this, you can go ahead and give a like and don't forget to share with a friend. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.